Cole, mouse. A very basic character and important radical. It forms a lot of characters that have something to do with mouse. Today we're going to go through some typical ones. We're going to have our lesson through short stories. Our first story is about this picture. A man is taking shower. Okay, our first character with mouse radical is 吃, to eat. 吃, 他洗澡前吃了一个汉堡。He ate a hamburger before taking shower. 他洗澡前吃了一个汉堡。Our second character with mouse radical is 喝, to drink. 喝。 Okay, now tell me, how do you say he drank a cup of wine before taking shower? That's right. 他洗澡前喝了一杯红酒。他洗澡前喝了一杯红酒。Great. Okay, next character with mouth radical is 唱, to sing. 唱。The sentence, 他一边洗澡一边唱歌。He was singing while taking shower. So, 一边 is a fixed structure when two actions take place at the same time. The sentence again, 他一边洗澡一边唱歌。Do you do that? Singing while taking shower? I like singing in shower. Okay, our next character is 吹, to blow. 吹, 他在用吹风机吹头发。He was drying his hair with a hair dryer because a hair dryer blows air out. 他在用吹风机吹头发。Okay, next character with mouse radical.叫, to call. 叫, we all know this in the sentence, 你叫什么? What's your name? But our sentence today is, 他叫了一辆出租车去机场。It's a little long. Again, 他叫了一辆出租车去机场。He called a taxi to take him to the airport.他叫了一辆出租车去机场。Okay, that's our first story. Remember this picture to review what we learned. He ate a hamburger, drank a cup of wine before he took shower, and sitting in shower. Later, he dried his hair with a hair dryer, and he caught a taxi and went to the airport. Now, our second story is about this picture. A man and his dog.Our first character is 舌, tongue. But most of the time we say 舌头 instead. Because, you know, the modern Chinese like words with two characters. 舌头, tongue. The sentence, 狗的舌头很长. Dogs have long tongues. 狗的舌头很长。Okay, next character is 咬, to bite. 咬, the sentence, 我家狗狗喜欢咬我的椅子。My dog likes to bite my chair. You might learn 我的狗, my dog, in textbook, but in real life, it's more possible you hear people say this. 我家狗狗, my dog.The sentence again, 我家狗狗喜欢咬我的椅子。So the dog of this man likes to bite his chair. So this day, he's biting it again. The man shouting to the dog, 别咬我的椅子。Don't bite my chair. 别咬我的椅子。And the dog said, that's right, this dog can speak.The more weird the story is, the deeper it sticks in your mind. So the dog said, 你不用喊, 我听得见。You don't need to shout. I can hear you. 喊 to shout. 喊你不用喊，我听得见。So it seems that the dog is a little upset for the owner scolded him. So he came close to the owner and he said, 我来告诉你一个秘密。Let me tell you a secret. 告诉 to tell. 告 is another character with mouth radical. 告诉 So the dog said,我来告诉你一个秘密。Let me tell you a secret. Actually, it's not a secret. He said, 吸烟对身体不好。Smoking is bad for health. That's right, the owner smokes. So the dog just said this to show the owner that we both have some bad habits. I have a funny image in my mind. What if two of them exchange the habits?Must be funny. 吸烟对身体不好。吸烟 to smoke. 吸 itself means suck. Because when you smoke, you suck the cigarette. 吸 The sentence again. 吸烟对身体不好。That's our second story. I hope you don't find it naive. Anyway, you can take the screenshot to keep this picture and memorize 5 characters with mouth radical. If you want to grow your vocabulary faster, I recommend to you the flashcard I make in HSK levels with beautiful pictures and useful sentences. They also help a lot to learn characters because one side of the cards are only with characters.And if you are just starting to learn the characters, we have cards and workbooks of the 100 fundamental characters in Chinese to help you to build a strong character foundation. I will leave the link in the description box. Okay, let's move on to the third story. This story is about a man is pretending illness to ask for leave from work. Okay, first, he said, 我已经咳嗽两天了。I've been coughing for 2 days. 咳嗽 to cough. Both of the characters have the radical mouth. 咳嗽 The sentence again. 我已经咳嗽两天了。And the manager didn't give him the permission. So he kept trying. He said, 这里太吵了。我头痛。It's too noisy here. I have a headache. Not sure why the office is too noisy. I'm just trying to make up the story. 这里太吵了。我头痛。吵 noisy. 吵。这里太吵了。我头痛。As you can imagine,The manager didn't give him the permission. So he continued and he said, 我有点想吐。I kind of want to throw up. 吐, another character with mouth radical. 吐, to vomit or to throw up. The sentence again, 我有点想吐。And still, the manager didn't let him go, but he didn't give up.He kept trying. He said, 我呼吸困难。I have difficulty breathing. 呼吸 Both of them have the radical mouth. 呼吸 To breathe. Sentence again. 我呼吸困难。It seems like it's getting serious. So finally, the manager gave him the permission. Okay, you're free to go.And this man, the moment when he got the permission, he called his girlfriend and he said, 我们去公园喂鸽子吧。Let's go to the park to feed the pigeons. Yes, as we already know, he was just faking it all the time. He just wanted to get out of work and have a relaxing afternoon. Anyways, the character 喂 to feed. 喂 Okay, the sentence again.我们去公园喂鸽子吧。 Okay, that's our third story about this picture. Keep it and review the words and sentences we learned with it. Okay, guys, we still have three important characters with mouth radical, but I'm kind of run out of imagination. So we're just going to learn them with a conversation between a student and a teacher. If you can make a funny story with these three words, please share with us in the comment section. I need to exercise my brain more. Okay, the student asked the teacher,
我能问你一个问题吗?
Can I ask you a question?
问, the character with mouth radical,
to ask.
问, 我能问你一个问题吗?
And the teacher said, of course, 当然, the student asked,
吓死我了,是什么意思?
What does 吓死我了 mean? The hint, 吓, it means to scare.
吓,
do you know what it means 吓死我了? That's right, it means you scared me to death. A very useful phrase in real life.
吓死我了.
So the teacher answered the student and he keeps asking,
我能再问你一个问题吗?
Can I ask you another question?
我能再问你一个问题吗?
The character 问, to ask. And the teacher said, 当然, of course. And the student asked,
闭嘴是什么意思?
What does 闭嘴 mean?
嘴 means mouth.
嘴. You might be wondering, 口 means mouth. And 嘴 means mouth too. What's the difference? Well,嘴 is how we say it in modern Chinese, to say mouth. And the character 口, nowadays, most of the time, we only use it to form other words, like 口水, saliva, or 口红, lipstick. Anyway, do you know what it means 闭嘴? That's right, it means close your mouth, or shut up. You would hear it a lot in TV dramas or movies, or in real life.I hope nobody say you that.
闭嘴.
So another useful phrase,
闭嘴.
Shut up. Okay, guys, keep these four pictures of today and use them as an anchor to review what we learned today. Hope you like today's content.
谢谢你收看我的视频。我们下次再见。
再见。